For the week of December 5th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Sailors who achieved the rank of Petty Officer 3rd Class after taking the Fall Advancement Exam were fortunate enough to learn the skills they need to be deckplate leaders during an indoctrination course taught by 1st Class Petty Officers on Yokosuka Naval Base. Petty Officer Adrian De Jesus, an instructor for the class, said the training was meant to create a foundation for leadership.
The training was to help the new 3rd Class Petty Officers understand the leadership role they are about to jump into. Give them that foundation, a strong foundation to become a better leader. The information is put from day one in boot camp. Everything is put up from day one to we really know how to use it.
Petty Officer 3rd Class Select Davier Shedrack, a student in the class, said he not only learned about what his new responsibilities will be, but what it means to be a leader.
This week, we mainly learn about the responsibilities that we now uphold as a petty officer, honor, courage, commitment, their definitions, what they mean, what they should stand for, and they stand for as it is now in the Navy. We can't just stop learning now. We gotta keep learning and help each other, you know, to make this Navy a greater Navy.
Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
What does an 8.0 magnitude earthquake feel like?
It shakes you pretty violently. It's 8.0. And like they have your drawers or cabinets from like your house actually fall out to a certain position.
Commander U.S. Naval Forces Japan's Fire Department's earthquake simulator, the Quake Cottage, is designed to bring awareness to the dangerous realities of earthquakes in Japan.
I've seen handouts and I've seen literature that says in an 8.0 you won't be able to move, and really that earthquake trainer drove that home because the violence of the situation was really overwhelming.
The earthquake simulator was part of a hands-on safety stand-down.
Our event today is really our fifth annual DLA Distribution Yokosuka Japan and partner Forklift Rodeo, but this year we've actually coupled it with an interactive safety rally.
Participants learned about fire prevention and fire safety and how to be prepared for a major disaster or earthquake.
I hope that this prompts some external discussion, maybe back with the family at home, how to formulate a solid plan should another earthquake happen.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
The fifth annual Forklift Rodeo kicked off at Commander Fleet Activities Yokosuka.
I believe it brings out a morale of, you know, we all come together, different nations, people come out and have a good time, compete, so that we all are together here at Yokosuka Base.
Seven teams made of sailors and master labor contractors compete for trophies and bragging rights.
Well, we work with forklift and supplies every day, so command decided to make an event for a forklift. We're gonna try to win it, but most of these guys have been driving forklifts for 20 years, so it's gonna be really hard to beat them, but we'll just give it our best shot.
Participants faced off in 5 challenges designed to test maneuverability skills and equipment knowledge.
It was pretty intense, I guess you could say. You know, a lot of different forklifts I drove here compared to what I'm usually driving. So that's probably the hardest part out of everything.
With safety always being a top priority, this rodeo competition offers personnel who use this equipment every day a fun and academic way to refresh safety and operational procedures.
The rodeos are basically safety events. They focus on the safety along with a little bit of relaxation and entertainment as part of the job to try to take a little bit of the academic part out of safety, make it more of an event that you can have at work.
Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.